Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. In this episode, we're going to create this text transition that you're seeing now using a particle system that's native to After Effects. We'll create this using a few effects, some scripts, and some adjustment layers that will allow you to easily animate text, images, or video off and on. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so I'm working in After Effects 2018, so we can just click this new composition button right here. And let's just call this particle transition. And 1920 by 1080 is fine, 2997, 10 seconds. Let's click OK. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a color controller. So let's go to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, rename that Color Control. And with that layer highlighted, let's go up to Effect, Expression Controls, and choose Color Control. Let's create some text. So Control T to bring up your text tool. Let's highlight that layer and Control Alt Home. Put the anchor point right in the middle. Let's go to our line panel and just center that text to the middle of our composition. Okay, now let's add a fill to this text layer. So Effect, Generate Fill. And now we're going to precompose the text layer. And the reason why is because you'll be able to put images or video or logos, anything like that, inside of this comp. Control Shift C to precompose and just call this Media. Now we need to link the fill. If you hit E on your keyboard, it brings up your effects. We need to link this fill over to this color control in the other comp. The way you do that, let's highlight color control. Just lock this down. Lock down the effects control by hitting this padlock right here. Go back into our media layer and just pick whip this color to our color control color. Okay, so now if we go back out to our particle transition comp, so you can see whenever you change the color, it will change your text and the other comp. Okay, and let's go ahead and add a background so that way we can kind of see some of the effects a little bit better. So new, solid, and this blue is fine. Just going to pull that underneath. And I'm going to lock that down so that way it doesn't move around. So in our effects and presets panel, I'm going to look for linear wipe. As long as you have this layer highlighted, you can just double click on linear wipe. Okay, so let's go to our 1 second mark and we want to put a keyframe here and hit U to bring up your, so that way we can see our keyframes. And let's just right click on this keyframe assistant, easy ease, or F9 for the shortcut. Go forward to 315 and let's just increase this to 100. So right now it's animating off, which is fine for this example. Change your feather to 50. I'm just gonna hit fit to fit this into our composition. That way it's full screen. Okay, so now let's duplicate this media layer, Control D, and rename this first effect. And I'm going to just get rid of this linear wipe because we don't need that for this layer. However, we do need some other effects. Now see, the color control is still locked. Make sure you unlock that. Okay, so now let's type in particle. CC Particle Systems 2. So with first effect highlighted, double click on Particle Systems 2. First, let's open up particle. Make sure you check this source alpha inheritance. And that's going to make your particles come from the source of this layer. We can move this over, and as you'll see, the particles dissipate once you leave the edge of your text. And this will be the same thing for if you have a logo in there or an image or video, anything like that. Okay, so now let's change our birth rate to 35, our longevity to 4. Let's open up producer. We'll just go straight down and make some changes here. This comp is 1920 by 1080, so our first keyframe will be 0, 540, and hit U to bring up our keyframes, and let's just change that to an easy ease, and let's go down to this last keyframe, and let's just change this to 1920. So this is going to go from 0 to 1920, so all the way across. Okay, so let's change our radius X to 1, and our radius Y to about 13. So on radius X, Alt click on there and just type in wiggle open parenthesis 10, 1. And then I'm just going to highlight that and right click and copy. Let's go to radius Y and click on that. We'll paste that, but let's actually make this wiggle 10, 10. And so that's going to kind of move our radius up and down on the Y axis very slightly and back and forth on the X axis. Let's open up our physics and we want to change explosive to direction normalized. I'm going to change our velocity to 0.3. Our inherent velocity, let's make that 30. Gravity, we want to go up instead of down, but just slightly, so negative 0.3. We want our resistance to be 20. And let's just change this extras from 1 up to 5. Let's open up our physics down here underneath our layer. Alt click on velocity, and I'm just going to paste that wiggle script, but it's going to be wiggle 10, 0.2 under inherent velocity. We're going to click on that and paste our wiggle, and we'll make that also 10, 0.2. Gravity, let's alt click on that. I'm going to paste our wiggle 0.3, so 10, 0.3. Resistance, we're going to alt click on that and paste our wiggle expression, and we'll make this 10, 15. Alt click on extra, paste that wiggle expression, and we'll do wiggle 10, 2. So this is just going to kind of randomize some of these settings and actually make it flow a little bit more naturally. We're going to change our birth and death color. We want that to map to our color control. Let's go up to our color control layer. And again, we're going to lock that down so that way we can click away and still have access to it. And then let's open up our particle setting underneath our effect. Let's just pick up this birth color to color control. And as you can see, it changed to that color. And same thing for death color, but we want our death color to be a little bit darker. So let's open up death color, and you can see this is the script that we get whenever we pick whip. Go to the very end of that and just type in times, so an asterisk 0.2, and that's gonna make it a little bit darker. So it's not quite black, it's just like a dark brown. And you can really see it if we start to change the colors here. So maybe that pink, that's like a really, really dark red. Okay, so I'm gonna choose maybe this blue color. And now see, this is a dark, dark blue. Okay, so let's keep moving forward. Make sure you uncheck this effect control so that way we can see what we're doing on these other layers. Go to our effect and presets panel and type in turbulent displace. And with first effect highlighted, double click on turbulent displace. We're gonna make some changes to these default settings. Amount 50 down to 35. Size, we're gonna leave it 100. And then for offset, we're gonna add a script. So let's open this up and go down to a turbulent displace and just alt click on offset. And type in the following value minus open bracket 0, time times 135 and close that bracket. Okay, for our complexity, we can make that maybe 3. Let's put a script on evolution. It'll be just a time script. So time times 135. And then let's open up our evolution options, and we're going to put a script on this random seed. So alt click on random seed, and I'm just going to type index times 3. It takes the layer number that this effect is on and makes that the random seed. First effect is on layer 2. Well, index times 3 is 2 times 3, and we have 6. And the reason why I want to do this is because we're going to duplicate this layer a couple of times. So the next two iterations of this layer are going to have a different random seed automatically generated because of this index times 3. And I do want to add one more effect to this layer. Type in drop shadow, and we're just going to double click on drop shadow. And then I already have some settings that I've experimented with that work really well. So 50%, degrees 200, distance we're going to make 50, and softness 150. I want to add a drop shadow also to our text. So if you highlight this drop shadow here, just control C, let's go into our media comp. I'm going to turn on our transparency so that way we can see it better. And I'm just going to paste that drop shadow. So let's make this 10 and this 15. We can increase this maybe to 75%. And see, and I didn't want to do it on our pre-comp because you may have a different setting for your drop shadow depending on whether or not you're using a video or an icon. It's just easier to make all of those changes inside of the pre-comp that holds that media. Keep moving forward. We need to duplicate this first effect layer. So control D. I'm going to rename this to second effect. And then I'm going to make some changes to the effects we already have over here. So let's make our birth rate 45. Let's open up our physics tab, and we want to change direction normalized to jet sideways. So that way we have even more variation. Let's maybe change our inherent velocity to 45 and make our extras instead of 5. Let's change that to 2. Okay, now I want to add one more thing to this layer. So let's go to our effects and presets and type in fast box and double click on fast box blur. So we're just going to add this to our second effect for right now. And we're going to make our box blur radius, we'll set it to 2. And see, it just kind of gives it some depth. You can like really see if you turn this off and on, it just kind of gives it something that looks a little bit more polished. Okay, and then for our drop shadow, let's move that below our fast box blur. We want the drop shadow to come last. Let's leave our distance at 50, but make our softness 70. And we want to make our opacity 100%. And then let's duplicate this second effect layer. So control D. Rename this third effect. And then we're going to make some slight alterations to these effects as well. So let's make our birth rate, let's set that up way up to 100, but we'll change our longevity down to 1 instead of 4. Let's change our track mode in this third effect layer from normal to add. Let's open up physics and change jet sideways to twirly. Open up your particle setting and let's change our opacity map from fade out to oscillate. Change our fast box blur settings from 2 to 3. Fast box blur is a very sensitive blur, so just changing it 1 point is going to add quite a bit. And then for drop shadow, let's change these settings because it's a little strong, maybe down to 50 opacity. And then for softness, we'll make this 150, and distance, we'll make that 35. One of the changes I do want to make really quick, just because if you put anything else into this media pre-comp, an issue that you may run into, depending on how tall it is how these particles are generated. So some of this first effect here, if we go to our particle systems too, under producer, this radius Y, this is what is controlling the height of these particles. I'm just going to solo first effect and media. So what I want to do is make sure my second and third effect are going to be the same as my first effect, but I don't want to change it every time. So with first effect highlighted, let's lock down that effect control. Now let's go ahead and uncheck these, and we can open up our second effect, open up particle systems, open up producer, and then for radius Y, we want to pick whip that to our radius Y of our first effect. Okay, and then you see the number just changed there. Do the same thing for third effect, open up effects, particle systems 2, open up producer, and just pick whip this radius Y to our first radius Y. If we open up this radius Y, we see now that our wiggle expression has gone, but that's okay because it's using the wiggle expression from the first effect. So whatever we set our radius Y to on our first effect will automatically update on our second and third. Let's uncheck that. So see, this is set to 20 on radius Y. Make that 50. See, our number with the wiggle expression is 51.3. Second effect is the same thing. Third, if we open up our producer, it's the same thing. Starting with After Effects 2018, you can pick whip pretty much any element of any effect or any layer. For the most part, anytime you see a pick whip, that means you can parent that to another layer and it will follow it exactly. Okay, so I'm going to change this back to 13. Now I'm going to bring in an image real quick. Let's go into our media comp here, and I'm just going to drag in this Apple logo right here. It's an EPS file, so I'm going to rasterize this so that way I can increase the size and not lose any quality. Get rid of our text layer. I'm just going to shy it away, and maybe let's give this Apple a fill. So you can open up your text layer and just right-click on color and choose copy expression only. Go up to our Apple layer here and then go to edit paste, and it will paste that expression. So I got to our particle transition. So now you can see instead of the text layer, we have this Apple logo. Well, see, it's a little bit different. So you may have to kind of change some of your settings. So like if we make our radius Y a little bit taller, maybe 50, you see how now it really starts to form over the Apple better. Let's go to layer, new adjustment layer, and then let's rename this radius Y height. And then we're going to go to effect. Expression controls, slider control. Okay, so now remember that our third and second radius Y effect is being linked to our first effect. But now we have this slider control. So all we have to do, let's lock this down, open our first effect, and remember our radius Y. So let's just pick whip this up to slider control. And then at the end of that, type plus wiggle 10, 10. But now we can control the height of this using the slider control. So say we go back to this media here and say we want to use this logo instead. Now we just go to our slider control. We're going to just unlock that. We can increase this so it will set instantaneously. Instead of having to go in there, you can just make whatever adjustment you want to make to this just to make sure it covers your Apple better. See how you kind of tweak with these settings to get the right kind of look. And so we go back to into our media and now let's use the text layer. We don't think this looks quite right. It looks a little bit off. Well, now we can just adjust this slider control to get exactly what we want to get. So the whole point is that instead of having to remember to go back into this first effect and adjust this radius Y, now that we have this radius Y height slider control, you can easily adjust that. I hope this helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. I've included the project file in the description below, and I'd love to hear your feedback about this course and any other topic you'd like to see covered. Don't forget to be on the lookout for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, coming very soon. I'll give you more information about this course in the coming weeks. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.